TV are brought to you by Dan's Southside Marine. Fishing boats and pontoons sold and backed by great service. It's a showcase of the great sport in the state of hockey. And take a look at this crowd. The buzz has been in the air, Johnny, since we walked in the arena an hour ago.
It is. It's electric in here. And as I'm sure we're going to discuss later, it's two great teams. And for anyone that's followed the tournament forever, this is Louis's last game. Let's hope it's a great one.
You know, these two teams have really not been tested yet in the tournament. How do you think they'll respond if it's a one-goal game?
It's a great question, Joel. It's whoever can get to that high level right away. They have not been pushed to that pace. They haven't seen that skill or speed yet. You can hear the crowd. Everyone's ready to go. Let's have that great game.
And Chan Hansen comes out and the crowd gives him a nice cheer. Let's be honest, they boot you down a little bit. That kind of happens when you win all those state championships.
Yeah, when you're here every year, the way Edina is, it happens that you know, the crowd doesn't like you, but hey, Edina is a class program. They do things the right way. They're incredibly well coached. They're a great team, and they're a great program. Let's hope this game lives up to what it could be.
Yeah, we talk about the goalies. We got two good experienced goalies. Camp Hendrickson and Chan Hansen has been outstanding, but he hasn't had to make many big saves yet.
He hasn't. This is probably the first time in the history of the state high school hockey tournament both goalies catch right-handed. I can't get over it. Still bothering me. Let's hope they make lots of great saves.
Does that make it different when you come in as a shooter?
I think so. For me, it always did, and I'm sure a lot of players will tell you the same. It is very rare to see a right-handed catching goalie, and we have two of them tonight, which is really
cool.
Well,
we are going to have a special moment for a special guy, and let's send it down to PA announcer Jim Carroll.
Number 7, Andy Earl. Senior floor number 8, Jake Rich. Senior floor number 9, Jack Chris. Senior floor number 11, Alex Jensen. Senior floor number 14, Gavin Uhlenkamp. Senior floor number 16, Tyler Smith. Senior defensive number 18, Chase Boreen. Junior floor number 19, Ryan McPartland. Senior defensive number 21, Ben Curtis. Senior floor number 24, Caden Lee. Senior floor number 25, Braden Willis. Senior defensive number 26, Colton Lasadeso. Senior floor number 28, Nick Petka. Sophomore goalie number 33, Grant Anderson. And senior forward number 37, Micah Saxon. The assistant coaches are Zach Ridley and Sam Sather. Head coach is Sean Bloomfield. Now, let's meet the Hornets. Sophomore goalie number 1, Chase Bargard. Senior defense number 4, Barrett Dexheimer. Sophomore defensive number 5, Dylan DeBook. Junior defenseman number 6, Charlie Miller. Sophomore defensive number 7, Sam Peckham. Sophomore forward number 8, Caleb Pitsley. Sophomore forward number 9, Mason West. Senior forward number 10, John Halverson. Senior forward number 11, Ryan Flaherty. Senior forward number 15, Dylan Kerm. Ninth grade forward number 16, Freddie Schneider. Junior forward number 17, Quinton Schaefer. Senior forward number 18, Jackson Nevers. Sophomore forward number 19, Casey Vandertop. Junior defensive number 20, Robbie Hope. Senior forward number 21, Bobby Cowan. Senior forward number 22, John Wapinski. Senior forward number 23, Michael Risto. Junior defensive number 24, Christian Keel. And senior goalie number 30, Joe Bertram. The assistant coaches are Josh Harding and Dave Terwilliger. Head coach is Kurt Giles. Here are tonight's game officials on the lines, Jordan Schwant and Ben Yannis. Your referees are Dan Kovarik and Tony Lancet. At this time, we ask you to please rise. Please remove your caps and join the Edina Band under the direction of Andy Richter in the playing of our national anthem.
Storm have never been here before. We know Edina certainly has been. Louisville should be a really good it's really sizing up to be a good one tonight for the state title.
Well, number one and two seed going into the tournament, two of the top four seeds all year long. It's a dream matchup, but I think we're going to see an outstanding game here tonight.
Yeah, they have never played before, these two programs. How much do they know about each other?
Well, they know a lot because they watch all the film, but they haven't had a feel for the other team because they haven't played each other. So that's why this is going to be like a cat and mouse game early on to see as the coaches are going along what the feel is, how they want to play this game.
And as John Bull mentioned earlier on the pregame show, they really haven't been tested up to this point. We'll see who's up to the test early as we take a look at the goalies here momentarily. Those last-minute encouraging words around each other's net. Chan Hassan, the last one to break their huddle as we take a look at those starting goalies brought to you by local Holiday Station stores, part of the Circle K family.
Well, Joe Buckram, you can see his statistics, 1.63 goals against, 936 save percentage. And when you go to the other side, Cam Hendrickson, the most amazing thing, this kid's got a under 1.97 goals against and save percentage up there, 953. We haven't seen Cam Hendrickson really test in this tournament. He's only had 21 shots against him. And so we're going to see some stuff here tonight because Edina will get some opportunities on him. We'll see what kind of goaltender he really is. He's supposed to be maybe the best in the whole state. And he's going to have to be that tonight if they're going to go on and win.
And Lou, I got to say, you made it up here in record time after that very nice ceremony. And we are underway. And 5 seconds in, it's an icing here on Edina.
I feel like a hologram. I was there when I'm here, but they had it organized so well. I didn't even get my steps in. They had a golf cart take me from the locker room to the elevator, so it was good.
Oh, my. Good crowd here tonight. As expected, championship Saturday night, prime time. Two number nines that lead this team, both these teams, as the top centers. Chan Hassan had the puck. They centered it out. Here comes Nevers back, and they're offside looking for the other number nine, Mason West. So a couple of whistles here against the Hornets.
And an outstanding chant for Chan Hassan after winning that draw. We're going to see opportunities by both clubs here. Both these goaltenders are going to have to be sharp. And by the way, these are the two fastest teams in the tournament. If they stay away from offsides, we're going to see a track meet. They can really skate, and not just one line, all of the lines.
Willis again, Schneider. Schneider, just a freshman, centering that third line here for the Hornets. Cam Hendrickson handling the puck back behind the net. Hornets get there. They'll push it up now to Storm. Andy Earle sends it in on Bertram. And Joe Bertram playing things safe early on. Both teams, I'm sure, they have some nerves here going into this championship game.
That's perfectly put. That's why I think we're seeing as many nerves. First of all, you got a nice and early, then you get goaltender freezing the puck when he has a chance to play. They're nervous. It's going to take a couple minutes to get through this, and that's why each of the coaches probably get their lines up on the ice as fast as they can, so they all got to feel.
Orpinski took the draw there against Brayden Willis. Back behind Joe Bertram here in the Edina zone. Chan Hassan trying to kick it to his blade was Andy Earle. Swung and missed. Got a man out in front. The Hornets have the puck here in their own zone. They'll bounce it out to neutral to center circle. To track it down, Halverson. Back in neutral. Big check delivered by Dyna defenseman Charlie Fellner. Back to the Storm from behind their net, coming back 200 feet.
I think you're going to see Dyna be physical tonight. They know they've got to slow Chan Hassan down. Chan Hassan's not big. They're really fast. And I would expect that Dyna will use their body whenever they can.
Hornets get to it first. And a quick turnaround shot. Pitsley. Pick save Hendrickson. Pitsley trying to keep it in. Now bounces out to neutral. Two on two here at neutral. Zigzag. Storm come in with McPartland. Stick handled and lost it. And then Saxon has it from a short angle. Saved by Bertram. Rebounding Dyna again up to Dexheimer. Who comes into the 10-game point streak. Solid check in front of the benches and then bank back into the Hornets.
And you can expect a lot of checks in the neutral zone because there's not going to be much room for either of these teams. I think they'll have tight gaps all night long.
West behind the Storm net. Mason West, the sophomore, football quarterback, top line center. Jackson Nevers, the Mr. Hockey candidate. Right side, quick shot, blocked and scooped by Cam Hendrickson, and then crashing into the net. Chan Hassan there to support their goaltender.
Well, he had a little help going into the net. You see it, Dyna hit right there, as you said before, a heavy check, and now you see Chan Hassan following up with one right there. So you're going to see every time these kids get a chance to bang one another, they're going to because they know each of these clubs has great speed. And the way you slow down speed is by body checking.
Oak sends it wide of the net. Up and out here by Jan Hansen all the way down. Icing this time on the Storm.
And for the hockey fans that haven't been following high school hockey, even though the Storm was in position to play the puck, beat the defenseman down there, it's automatic icing in high school. It's not like the pros. And high school does that for a good reason. They don't want any type of opportunity to have collisions and run into the boards from the full length of the ice.
There's a Jack Crist line for Jan Hansen. That line's been outstanding. Crist had two goals last night, three for the tournament. Dino holds it in. Diskins. Reed Larson finalist for Defenseman of the Year. Bobby Cowan. A couple of goals last night. Goes forward to corner. Gets it stripped away by Lawson Gesso. Not yet out from behind his own net. Owen Biskins. Lawson Gesso and Biskins make a nice defensive pair as Biskins dumps it in.
And that was a good play by Lawson Gesso, taking Cowan's body as he's going around the net. He's done it four times in the last two games. He goes around the net freely and comes up with the puck. He gets opportunities and creates opportunities. That time, the defenseman took him up.
Schneider trying to get going. He was hit by Braden Willis. Storm into the zone. Left wing. Shot by Smith. Stick save Bertram. Another one comes in on Joe. And a juggling grab with it. John Cole mentioned it. Both right-handed catching goalies.
Yeah. You know, you don't see that much. No five play goal would be that way. But here's a heavy check right here. As you can see, you're going to see a lot of that. Lawson Gesso, good check there. Here's a save from Bertram. And kicks it off to the side. These teams are coming here to play. They've shown it already. And they are continuing contact with the puck carrier.
Willis wins the draw. Storm then get it low. First of all, Edina gets to it, though. In their own zone. Now they work it back down low. Freddie Schneider back behind the net. Peckham trying to swing it around. Not yet out. But Andy Earle centering. Picked off Warpinski and now up to neutral.
And you can see how quick both these teams are.
Warpinski picks it up, backhand to the net. Hit his own guy who was going through the slot. And the Storm with numbers on their shorts, a.k.a. Breezers. It's a sharp look. Dump back in. I would imagine these Chan Hansen jerseys have the Lou Nanny seal of approval.
Yeah, we like that. We can see the numbers here. They're a lot better than their current home jerseys.
Hornets, Halvorsen tried to play it out in front. Chan Hansen picked it up, and it's still loose. Vandertop has a hat trick in the tournament. Hitzley in the corner. Hornets are getting the puck to the goal mouth a couple of times here.
Those two guys, Pitsley and Vandertop, and Lynn Flaherty, they've had a terrific tournament.
Icing once again here, this time on Chan Hansen. Shots are 4-2 in favor of the Storm.
Yeah, and the shots are coming from all angles. We really haven't seen any right at the doorstep. And that's good that these teams are thinking, shoot. Doesn't matter where you are, you got to shoot. Because right now, the way you're going to beat these goaltenders, it seems, is with a rebound. So keep shooting and somehow, some way, produce a rebound and somebody can bang it in.
Cam Hendrickson, the Frank Brimsek finalist, 7 shutouts of the season. He's faced only 23 shots on goal, 22 saves here in the state tournament. Played all but 2 games here this season. And of course, Joe Bertram on the other side. Opportunity coming in for Chris. Put on the brakes. Denied up to the point. Biskins. Back play out in front.
Replay by defenseman Holt for Edina.
Here come the Hornets back. Nevers gets it back up to the blue line and back to the Edina zone.
Good block by Biskins there when he's one-on-one with Nevers. Didn't let that shot go through. Both of these clubs have excellent defense. They handle the puck well, they check well, and they play position well.
Here comes Nevers. Into the corner. Storm will win the race to it. Biskins in the middle, kicking it around. Hartland gives it off to Risch. Risch running into resistance in the circle. Up to the point, held in Jensen. And it ends up coming back out to neutral in front of the benches. Jensen again here for Chan Hansen. Dumps it. Bertram got a piece of it. First one to it. Peckham for the Hornets. Up off the wall. Vandertop now out. Another chance for Peckham here. This time goes up high. And it comes out to neutral. Pushed down the far side. Hitzley in a race. Jensen pulling. Up and out.
Edina was on the line change defense weren't quite out there yet, so the puck went back to the blue line. Had no takers. Donner tips it in. McNeely goes back. Chanhassen defensive core pretty deep. Here's a stat, Lou. For both teams, the top nine forwards for both teams all have points in the tournament.
Oh,
that's a good offense these clubs have. They move the puck around and they take shots. They know how to put it in the net. And that'll be icing. Called here on Chanhassen. We will step aside for the first time. First period. No score.